BBC Audio presents The Chief Inspector Dover Mysteries, a collection of six entertaining thrillers featuring the slovenly sleuth, Scotland Yard's most unwanted man.
Dover Goes to Pot by Joyce Porter. Dramatised for radio by Paul Mendelson.
From Sergeant Charles McGregor, Scotland Yard, application for transfer, number 23. I know it has long been a tradition that when an outlying county cannot, or will not, handle a major crime, they call in Scotland Yard. I simply have two questions. First, why do you always persist in sending Chief Inspector Dover? And second, why, oh why, does he always ask for me to go with him?
McGregor! Come on, man. We don't have all blasted night. Hurry up with those cases.
I'm coming, sir. There don't seem to be any porters on the platform this evening.
Flaming typical. They dispatch us to the backside of nowhere and expect us to find our own way to our billet.
I think it all looks rather pretty, sir. All those rolling hills and dales. And did you see that beautiful wee church?
All I can see is rain and ruddy Yorkshire. Why isn't anyone here to meet me?
Well, sir.
Chief Inspector Dover?
That's me. Dover of the Yard, in the flesh. Grab hold of these, laddie, but don't go expecting a tip.
I'm not a porter, I'm Inspector Bream, local CID.
How are you now?
Yes. Welcome to Potwinkle, sir. We've a car waiting for you. I think you'll like it.
A car's a ruddy car, isn't it? McGregor, don't dawdle and get that brolly up, pronto.
Yes, sir. Please, God, send him pneumonia. Oh.
Well, I must say, Sunshine, you're the first police force I've ever come across to use one of these, eh, McGregor?
It's a Rolls-Royce Silver Cloud, sir. 3.8 litre.
Yes, but it's not ours. It belongs to Daniel Whibley. We're on our way to see him now.
Who the blazes is he when he's at home?
Daniel Whibley is the most influential man in Potwinkle. He runs this town, Chief Inspector. Whibley Sanitary Ware. You must have seen the name.
Think I've got eyes in me posterior, do ya? So why is this Whibley fella doing the honours?
Well...
Oh, look! A cocktail cabinet. Yeah, let's see.
Sir...
Parched after that journey.
Sir, it's Mr. Whibley's daughter who's been murdered.
Oh, yes. Was she married?
Yes, she was.
Husband knocking him out?
Well, yes. Actually, he was the one who found the body.
John Perkins.
Yes, that's him.
Well, what are you sweating about? Just clap the old iron bracelets on this Mr. Whoever and shove him in the pokey. He'll be your man, all right? Always is, now.
Oh, steady on, Chief Inspector. That's a bit sweeping, isn't it?
You trying to tell me how to suck eggs, matey? A glorified traffic warden? I think not. Look, McGregor. Cigars. I'm going to like this Whibley fella.
I'll get right to the point. Chief Inspector Dover, is it?
That's him, Mr. Whibley. Dover of the Yard. Oh, are those sandwiches for me?
No, they're my supper. Can we discuss the case?
No time like the present, sir. You'll find I'm a driven man, Mr. Whibley. Driven. Ask my sergeant here, McGregor. What am I?
Driven.
The reason I asked my friend, the Chief Constable, to call you chaps in is that I don't want there to be the slightest hint of suspicion that I've influenced the outcome of this case. And, as we all know, Scotland Yard is above reproach.
Absolutely. You know, one of those malt whiskies would go down a treat while you film me in.
On you go. Cynthia was only 21. 3 years ago, quite against my wishes, she married John Perkin, the son of one of our factory workers. Don't ask me why. Apparently, she loved him. The female heart, Dover.
Yeah.
And since then, she's lived on one of those soulless housing estates they throw up these days. Totally unsupported by me.
What does this Mr. Perking do, sir?
I'll ask the question, McGregor.
Sorry, he's sir. The manager of a small travel agency in the town.
And your daughter?
Whibley women don't work, Sergeant. Cynthia stayed at home, which is where she was found yesterday afternoon. Beaten to death with a poker. poor girl.
Sometime between 4:30 and 6:30, I believe.
Oh, do you now? Couldn't these local wallers be more precise than that?
Perhaps she was by the fire, sir. That would affect the onset of rigor mortis.
Exactly. Trained in myself, you know.
Her husband discovered her body when he returned from work. Then he contacted the police. He's now staying with his married sister in Canal Bank Street. That's in the poorer end of town.
Well, that gives me something to be getting on with. Now, it's very late and I haven't eaten since supper time.
I'm not finished.
Sit down, Sergeant.
As you're aware, Chief Inspector, capital punishment's been abolished in this country, a most retrograde step, in my opinion.
You're dead right there, Mr. Wibbly. Criminal, I call it. So does McGregor.
Well, actually,
I'm glad to hear it, so I'm relying on you not just to get my poor daughter's murderer to trial, but to expose him as a cold-blooded, deliberate killer. I want him to throw away the key, Dover.
That's as may be, Mr. Wibbly, but we've got to catch our murderer first, ain't we?
Good heavens, man, everybody knows who he is. He's John Perking, my daughter's wretch of a husband. Now, could you and I have a few quiet words alone?
McGregor, scoot.
Sir?
Just wait outside.
Yes, sir.
Now, Chief Inspector, I suggest a little quid pro quo.
Boom, 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 boom.
You seem happy, sir. So, what was it Mr. Wibbly wanted to talk to you about? Something about a quid?
Never you mind.
Okay. So, we know Mr. Wibbly refused to give the young couple a penny once they got married.
Made their bed, had to ruddy lie in it.
But Cynthia would inherit all Mr. Wibbly's interest when he died, presumably.
What are you getting at, laddie?
Well, if she had no money to leave her husband, why on earth did he murder her?
Probably got sick of her stupid face. You do, you know. Good effect.
Here you are.
I'll take a few. Could be a long night.
What if, say, they had children?
Oh, you and your what-ifs. Wibbly did say something about a grandkid naturally changing things. But they didn't have any nippers, did they? Not for the want of trying, by all accounts, but after 3 years, not a sign.
No. Oh, what a pity. So, is there a Mrs. Wibbly?
There is, but they're long separated. He only married her for her money.
So when he started to make money of his own?
Exactly. She wouldn't give him a divorce, though. Women can be so bitter, Sergeant. Now, let's take a quick shifty at the crime scene, then you can arrest young Perkin.
If we have reason to believe he did it, sir.
You and your police college slogans.
Chief Inspector Dover, Constable Harris. Miserable night, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yes, well, if you'll follow me, gentlemen. The poor young woman's still in the living room. Husband found her. In quite a state he was. We haven't touched anything.
I'll touch the kettle, will you, Constable? I need a cuppa fast.
Very good, sir.
Sir, fingerprints?
Reckon the murderer made himself a cup of tea, do you?
All I meant was...
Now, let's have a good butcher's at the late Mrs. Perkin.
Oh, Struth.
What a way to go.
Bit of a look or two. Oh, well.
So, this the murder weapon?
Well, it seems likely, sir. The lab will tell us for sure.
So, it must have been someone who knew the poker was here, and who better than hubby, eh?
Isn't that jumping to conclusions, sir?
No. Constable, any sign of breaking in?
Apparently not, sir. Either Mrs. Perking let her murderer in, or he let himself in with a key.
Which means the husband. So, were you first on the scene?
No, sir. It was Arnold. PC Jenkins. Nice young lad. And you know what struck him most, I'll tell you? It was how it all looked so homely. Nice blazing fire, telly still on.
The television was still on.
Don't get caught up in trivia, McGregor. Come on, better search the kitchen.
Looking for clues, eh, Chief Inspector?
That and cake. Very partial to Madeira. McGregor, go and wake up some neighbours.
Yes, sir. But please don't touch anything else. You know, evidence.
Bit keen, isn't he?
He'll get over it. Well, she kept her kitchen nice. I say that for the poor girl. This table's spotless. Now, what's in here? Ah, chocolate digestives. Cutlery drawer, Constable. You'd be amazed what I've seen put back in cutlery drawers.
Really?
Murder weapons cutlery. Right, now, what's in this pedal bin? Now, that's very interesting, that. See that, Constable?
Yes, sir.
Chief Inspector.
Where is it? Who's this?
This is Mrs. Carruthers. She lives next door. And Eric.
Hello. I had to bring my Eric his teething, bless him.
You any good with a kettle?
Yeah, of course I am.
Make us all a cup of dinner. Constable's bored it. Old McGregor.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.